All right, coming up next, it is a welterweight showdown between Leon Edwards and Nate Diaz. Well, enjoy him while he's here, folks, because you never know if this will be the last time we see Nate Diaz in the UFC. With a fan base really as big as any fighter in the sport, Diaz is back tonight, and we're glad to see him.
Doc, stand up. This guy has a cult following. He is one of the most interesting guys in the UFC because he has this sense that he really doesn't care to be here, but he also doesn't feel as comfortable anywhere but in the octagon. So it's a love-hate relationship with fighting for Nate Diaz. When he's happy, when he's best, he's fighting in the UFC. A guy that boxes, unbelievable, but I think it's the attitude of Nate Diaz that has made him into one of the biggest stars that we've ever seen in the octagon.
He had a couple of life-changing paydays against Conor McGregor, the win at UFC 196, the majority decision loss at UFC 202.
Which to this day he says he won, right?
He thinks he won that fight. But one thing goes without saying, and I'll say it anyway, when Nate Diaz fights, the world is watching, and that is the case yet again here tonight. All right, well, I'm excited for this one. This is a kickboxer of the highest order. He has so many different kicks and punches in his arsenal and figures to try to keep this on the feet here tonight.
The beautiful thing that he does is throw that front push kick to create distance when a guy starts to get too close and wants to wrestle with him. He throws it, and the moment you're back at his range, he starts to blast high kick. He doesn't always intend on landing, but he beats up your arms with high kick after high kick after high kick. And then as you get desperate, you start to run into knees, and he does not need much space to land a knockout punch. This guy is one of the best strikers we've ever seen in the UFC.
And if you don't find the striking range early against this guy, you could be in real trouble.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out United Center in Chicago, Illinois, it's time! 5 rounds in the UFC welterweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 21 wins, 12 losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Fighting out of Stockton, California, he is an Ultimate Fighter season winner, Nate Diaz! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 3 losses, and 1 no contest. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 170 pounds, Leon Rocky Edwards!
All right, commit to the rules of the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, not fight.
You ready? You ready? Now let's go.
Well, it seems like this is an annual stop for the MMA leader as we are back and now underway with live action from United Center in the Windy City, Chicago, Illinois.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
That is a hard left hand that lands for Leon Edwards, and as usual, DC, letting his fighting do the talking tonight.
Letting his fight do the talking, man, he's all business. He's a businessman. He's here to win, go back to England, and do his thing with his family. He's not gonna be on TV hooping and hollering. He's a guy that's here to do his job and then go back home until he gets his title. He's giving him so many different things right now. Ooh, what a punch.
Rock'em sock'em out of the chute here. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. Well, a lot of people think he might have the best jab in this division, certainly using it effectively here.
I mean, one of the best jabs in the world across all combat sports. The way that it just comes out, it's beautiful. The backside hand is always at the chin. The elbows tucked to the ribs. The jab goes out. The jab comes right back to the face. It's picture-perfect technique, almost like a Taibo class or something like that.
So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Nate Diaz.
Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Oh, vicious kick to the outside of that lead leg. You got to start checking these, man.
You got to check these kicks, or you're going to be limping around the octagon very short.
Check yourself before you wreck yourself.
Check it.
3 minutes have elapsed here in round one. Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots. Almost in range with the straight left, but that's a miss.
Oh, that's a nice strike.
Diaz gets absolutely pelted by that head kick. Ooh. Try to establish that jab. Got clipped with the right hand. Well, he continues to offer up the kick here, but just misses with that one. Diaz gets caught by that straight punch. That'll get his attention.
Nice, looping punch.
Edwards gets tagged again.
Nice leg kick.
Oh, and he tags him with the straight, beautifully placed there by Edwards.
I mean, over and over, he is taking these strikes to the head.
And he landed the right hand there. All right, let us look back at some of the action from that previous round. DC punches in bunches.
I mean, over and over, he landed that big punch. And every time he landed it, he got the reaction that he was looking for. His opponent really did start to take notice every time he was loading that strike up.
All right, here we go as our next round gets underway. That was some serious precision striking on display in the previous round. Found his openings upstairs and closed the show.
He has landed at an alarming rate. His opponent needs to get his head off the center line. He's walking into him with his head straight up, not moving, trying to engage without changing the angles. That is why he is getting brutalized right now.
Really timing his shots nicely. Good tempo, very accurate, finding the range with relative ease.
Yeah, he's doing a great job of really overwhelming his opponent with activity.
So as we call on the numbers, 54 total strikes have now landed for Leon Rocky Edwards. And landing with 50% accuracy tonight against Nate Diaz.
Big punch land for him.
There's the leg kick, that one checked by Diaz. Oh, he landed that kick to the outside of the lead leg there, DC.
He is chopping.
Oh!
Dude's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
Now he's attacking the triangle.
Triangle looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like it's getting in deep.
All right, so he postures up. Nicely done. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
And he's able to work his way back to his feet. All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he has taken the message from his corner and picked up the pace here in round two.
Nice elbow. That's how he's cutting the point.
And now he's got that tie punch.
Punch over the top.
Well, he's always on the counterattack, but a nice leg kick there by Edwards. Diaz's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. Just misses with the right. That shot blocked by Diaz. All right, then a left.
Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down.
Oh, how about the head movement? Slips his head off the center line and then rips back.
Oh! He didn't like that left hand. He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out. Effective punch there by Edwards.
Oh,
hard shots landing on both sides here. All right, there's the end of the round. So it was a huge strike to the head that stunned his opponent and nearly got him out of it.
Yeah, that was a big moment. A big strike lands, his opponent's on wobbly legs. That is exactly what you want to see as you're walking back to your stool. Your opponent staggering back to his corner and being hopeful that he can get it back together before the start of the next round.
All right, next round is now underway. DC, any major takeaways after the previous 5 minutes?
That both of these guys are very evenly matched. The matchmakers did a fantastic job when they put these two in the octagon. So even though it wasn't crazy, you got to see high-level mixed martial arts.
Tries to mix in a takedown here. Well, we wondered earlier why there weren't as many body strikes. He's making up for lost time here. Shot to the body connects. And that bears watching. That's going to hurt this opponent.
Nice punch lands over the top.
Just misses with the straight left hand. Nice connection there by Nate Diaz. Not a guy you want to let get going here on the feet, DC.
No, because this is exactly what he needed to get a takedown and secure the position.
All right, DC, half guard position here. You've done a lot of good work in this spot in your career.
Oh, man, I love this position. And you see this fighter today loves it, too. It is the most secure position in fighting. You get an underhook on one side, you keep a half guard on the other, and then you just go to work. It's the safest position, especially for a wrestler.
All right, north-south position now. We'll see how he chooses to proceed. All right, working inside the closed guard now.
Watch the legs going up around his neck. His opponent better react right now before he starts to get the angle on his triangle choke.
Oh, he postured up there.
Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
All right, well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you got to be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. How about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep.
Nice hammer fist.
Let's go. Get him off.
Under 2 minutes now to go. So 101 total strikes have landed for Leon Edwards. And landing with 55% accuracy against Nate Diaz. Oh!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press it. Chase that finish down now.
Oh!
He went high on that one.
Oh, he might be out. That one appeared to stun him.
What?
Whoa!
He's mixing up his target.
Wow!
Change.
Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's going to start looking to land big shots from the top.
Final seconds of round three. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Let's now look back at some of the action from that round. He went headhunting, landed, nearly got the finish, too.
A lot of coaches tell you don't headhunt. In this case, he's been headhunting. and he landed a big enough shot to truly put his opponent on notice.
Edwards gets caught with that punch. His chin is held up thus far. Got to shore up the defense here, though. Oh, beautiful straight left hand.
There's no tell on that leg kick.
Plans the right hand. Misses with the right hand.
Finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh, he might be out. Oh, straight right. Man, he's timing his shots nicely. It's like Tom Brady out there. He hasn't missed the target.
I mean, you insist on bringing in Tom Brady. Stop it. John, stop it.
Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? Jockeying for position here on the clinch. Both fighters trying to get a more dominant position. Oh, nice strike landed there by Diaz.
Big liver kick lands under the elbow. Left hand punch from the clinch. Big punch from the clinch.
Oh!
He's hurt. Serve him up. Go get him.
Now goes in and secures the takedown.
Now he sees the triangle.
And this could be trouble here. Looks like it's pretty tight. He's trying to work his head out of harm's way.
It might be over.
And he's out. Well, hard to win fights in mixed martial arts from the bottom, but nice work here in that position by Diaz. Oh, he's got the ground and pound going now. His opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen. He needs to push the arm to the side. Get his head against the mat. Now watch
it. And he's out. Keeping busy here off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Oh, tagged him with that right hand. What a strike that was.
What a strike that he is landing over and over again. His opponent will need to make some adjustments.
All right, well, he's got him softened up here. All right, side control now, DC. You know he's in his element on the ground. A lot of tricks up his sleeve.
A lot of tricks.
Oh, nice job working hard, posting, and getting back up.
Big kick lands.
Final seconds. Diaz's lower jaw is extremely swollen now. Horn sounds for the end of round four. All right, so there's the horn signifying the end of the round. We had a knockdown there, but not a knockout.
No, it wasn't a knockout, but you can't take those shots. That big punch landed, and it sat him down. If he gets hit with another one of those, it might be good night, Irene.
Last round, guys. You ready? You ready?
So here it is, folks. Fifth and final round. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh! Oh, he goes with the punch and he lands. Back mount now.
Now he'll try to start attacking a rear naked choke from the top position. He is doing a really good job of relaxing, not panicking because he's getting choked. Oh, he might have got him with a choke.
Wow. All right, full guard here, DC. What does he need to do to improve position?
Well, he's got to start to build his posture, get some damage off, move the half guard, which in turn leads to more opportunities poor advancement. But if you're on the bottom, you got to anticipate those movements. The moment he tries to move to the next position, you build a shield, get back to your feet, or dig an underhook to try to get a reversal or a sweep.
All right, so you got to be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. All right, operating inside the closed guard now. Well, you got to be working off of your back. He's certainly doing so here. Nice
punch. That guillotine. Watch guillotine.
He might get a finish here. Wow. Under 2 minutes now to go in the fight. Oh, an obvious limp there. His leg hurting for certain.
Nice strike.
Well, you've got to admire the urgency here. He is trying to keep the judges out of it, lighten up his opponent left and right. Oh, beautiful jab from Nate Diaz. If he gets that weapon going early, could be trouble.
Yeah, he starts touching you with the jab over and over again, and then when he starts to let that right hand fly, you start to see real big reactions from his opponent.
What a last minute!
Oh, he's hurt bad. He's hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. He's got to go chase that finish down now.
All right, rubber guard for him now, DC. We haven't seen you lean on this in the octagon.
No, I can't get those legs up there. Come on, man, look at these tree trunks. They don't go up around nobody's shoulders. I like to keep my feet on the ground, and I like to grind. That's what I'm known for. But this guy has that dexterity. He has that ability to throw up the rubber guard, to be able to threaten from a position where his opponent was trying to find safety. There are many, many attacks here. Let now, the guy's attacking the triangle. He finds himself in trouble because he got a little bit lazy in the full guard.
Looks like he's trying to manipulate the head. This could be tight. All right, so the fight goes the distance. Both guys had their moments, but there was a striking advantage, albeit slight, and perhaps that'll be enough for him to get his hand raised tonight.
It should be enough. I mean, when you watch the fight, you understand that you are watching two of the best mixed martial artists in the world. But it did look like he did just enough to earn a competitive decision.
Official decision now in, the Buff has it.
Ladies and gentlemen, after five rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision.
For the winner by split decision, Leon Rocky Edwards!
Ooh, those split decisions are something else. He is happy to exhale at this point in time. It was a close fight, and the judges certainly felt that way as well.
It's the worst feeling in the world. When you go to the middle and you're just not sure, your heart is beating so fast, especially when you hear your opponent's name called
right
before you ultimately win the fight. He put in a lot of work. He fought through the adversity and got the job done. He should be very proud.